We did it, Pete. With the, we said we would do it, and everything we do in life is always a we.
Hello, I'm Pete Casillas. I'm standing in the corner of Superior, Arizona, Main Street in Magma, beneath the beautiful Pachalip Mountain. I'm here with Joaquin Trujillo.
Good to see you, brother.
Good to see you. He just finished up a book, Living in Superior, Arizona from 1930 to 1950. He's going to be one of our guest speakers here at the Prickly Pear Festival. That is tomorrow, Saturday, August 18th. And it's at 10 a.m.?
10 a.m.
10 a.m. at the town hall. And just real quick, just give us a brief overview of how, your background and how you came to know Superior.
Sure. First, thanks, Pete. Project wouldn't have happened without you. We said we would do it.
Yes, sir.
And we did it, right? It's an American story, covers the years 1930 to 1950 in a historic mining town here in Arizona. And a geologically spectacular environment. As you can see, we're right beneath Apache Leap. It's a narrative history, meaning that I was derived from the interviews of persons that were born in the 20s and early 30s, and it was their stories of living in the town, of daily life, really, from doing business to raising your families to going to school to going to war. And I've had I have the privilege to present that tomorrow, Saturday, the 18th of August, 2018, at the 7th Annual Prickly Pear Festival, which is one of the most famous festivals in Arizona.
Yes, sir.
I interviewed 15 persons that were born in the 20s and early 30s, all families that have lived here most of their lives. From all different backgrounds and all different occupations, all different ethnicities. And we met over and over repeatedly, both in Superior and also in Phoenix. Phoenix is that way, which is the sixth largest city in America, about 1 hour this
day. People, they're interested in your book. Give us some bullet points of what they expect to read from this book.
An American story. Mm-hmm. That the struggles Americans endure, all the differences that make us one person, all these fundamental basic human themes that you find all over the planet, in every town, in every village, in every city. The importance of the town during this period in American history that helped define us as a people. The production aspect of the town, it was one of the most cost-efficient mines in the world. The fact that it was an underground mine, you didn't see it. If we point over here down Magma Avenue, that was the location of the mine. And you never saw it. There was a tunnel that brought the rock from underneath. That's now the location of Resolution Copper. That was the original Magma Heights and where the Magma Hospital was. Behind here to the right, on the other side of Magma Avenue, was Jiggerville. And a Jiggerville, with a J, Jiggerville, means a shift boss in mining. It means you're a supervisor in the mine. So that's where Magma employed its supervisors. And this is the main street. We're standing right in front of the historic Magma Hotel built in 1912 by McPherson, Mr. McPherson.
Where can they pick up your book?
Amazon.com. They should be offering it in the town soon.
All right, Joaquin, thank you for your contribution.
Thanks, Pete.
Forward to reading this.
So tonight we're going to go to Porter's for cervezas.
Meet us at Porter's.
We're going to go for drinks tonight to celebrate our success that
Absolutely.
We did it. We finished what we wanted to do.